Welcome back to, excuse me, Temple of Elemental Evil. What was I doing in the last part? Still trying to take a nap? Oh, wow, it actually happened. Holy crap. I'm legitimately, legitimately amazed. I was sure that I was going to,
yes.
End up in like 9 or 10 more combats until I actually managed to get...
Yes.
Healing, sleeping done. And 10 HP on a cure light wound? That's pretty damn good.
Yes.
Well, it's 1d8 plus his character level up till max of 5 on cure light wounds, if I'm correct, and I should be. Yeah, plus 4, so actually, yeah, that's alright. How's the jackal doing? The jackal is injured. Let's actually take care of that little guy, because,
yes.
To be honest, he's, pretty help too. Do I not get bonus healing
yes.
from domain spells? That's weird.
Yes.
Might as well just
yes.
heal up the, you know, jackal and just all that. The moon house is almost done, by the way. Oh, really? Filth fever. Oh, yeah, the dire rats. That's right. Oh, boy. She hasn't taken any penalties from it yet, though. That's good. Oh, I forgot how close you guys were up to, level the next level. Okay, Furnock, actually, let's switch you with the jackal. Since you're a rogue, you really shouldn't be up front that much. Also, my FPS dropped for some reason. Hold on. Return to game. Okay, I'm gonna cut all that out. I don't know why, it's just, graphically, it seems to be chugging a little bit. There should only be one place I haven't been. Because I killed the giant crayfish. I've done all of this. So there's just a little pathway down here that I haven't gone through yet. Which isn't bad. Well, the moat house, as long as it has taken me, is actually pretty damn small. When you start comparing it to, actually, wait a minute, guys. Oh. Yeah, the moat house is really, really tiny. Especially compared to things later in the game, and there's another site of my massive massacres. Well, that floor is all pleasant-like. Oh!
Right away.
Oh yeah, that's right, there's a little, there's an extra exit for the moat house, which is quite handy. You can't get here any other way. You're not gonna randomly find this wandering around the world. You have to go through the moat house to find it. There's really no point in, it's a nice way to leave it, but I don't see why you'd want to come back.
Right away!
What is this place? Look, I need to get through here. How would you pronounce that? He runs to the back. Yeah, I'm about to get into a very, very massive combat. Could everyone please come into the hallway? And, Ulk, why are you... I swear, these people just want to be in the wrong positions all the time. I have told you that the moat house is almost over. Time for the big fight of the moat house. Yeah, the bugbear thing? No, that wasn't that big. It gets much worse. Ulk, what are you doing? Party order, you're back here! Stop being stupid. You shouldn't be in the front. See? Where you're standing is much more logical. Why did you keep going all the way up to the front? Is it because you couldn't fit sideways? You went, oh, the next best place for me to be is way up front? Um. Yeah, this combat is rather massive. Ulk! First thing you're going to do, and you probably know exactly what I'm doing, is we're going to enlarge Stumpy. It's still working. I'm going to keep doing it. Parjani, could you step up
a little?
No, I guess not. I need to get other people out of your way. Because one of the reasons I pick up Warpwood is because Warpwood has the potential to completely destroy ranged weapons, making them useless. Just imagine a bow getting all twisted. Of course it's not going to work.
By the gods' will.
Fernok.
Certainly.
Of course you miss. Wow, me just randomly doing this without really... Actually, first thing I need to do with you is definitely bless, because I went through this combat earlier with this party. Of course, considering this is my only save. Things went very well, I'd have to say. Probably not so much this time. Last time, Lily had already killed the two people. I'm all stuck in the doorway, too. I need to get people in. It's very strange for people with pole arms to do something and then move away.
That will require a mere fraction of my power. Yes.
Yeah, I can't target them because they're out of line of sight. I need to get in the room. Please don't hit me. Especially Parjani. Oh, you know what else I could do? None of that. Let's... I want to keep warp wood. I don't want to waste that. Bark skin. Yeah, let's waste full strength.
Of course.
Get out that earth elemental. Just, yeah, she can. Can you move forward a little bit? Apparently not. Oi! Scorching Ray. Badly injured at 16. That's not bad. I need to get in the room.
By the gods' will. Right away.
Fernok's gonna bite the big one. Can I get in this room, please? I need to get Stumpy in, and I need to get Fernok out. Fernok is not happy right now. And I can't get you up to heal him because everybody's in the doorway. Methinks I'm going to have to reload at this point. Critical hit, can't cleave because, well, he can't reach anyone. Stumpy's in the room. There's a vast improvement. Now to get Fernok out. Well, he has 53 HP. I'm not too worried about... Oh, well, now that's a little bit much. Could you please stop?
Yes.
Ulk. Not going to dismiss spells. Yes. That's just stupid. Can we get rid of this guardsman? Yes.
Yes, sir.
Can you warp wood, please?
Right away.
Can. /4, what? Come on, game.
Yes, sir.
Alright. Weapon destroyed. He can no longer use his weapon. It didn't work on the two other guys, but that's fine. I took one of them out.
Right.
I'm kind of surprised that, didn't work on more of them, because I believe, memory serves, it's running off of their personal saves themselves type of opportunity, and all of that, and she still misses. Oi. Fernok, I need you to get the hell out of Dodge. Yeah, you... I got you out just in time. 16 disabled, exertion, good job, Lareth. You, sir, yes. Can you heal Fernok, please? Thank you. Almost lost him.
You have earned my wrath. As you command.
16? 15. Haha. Stumpy, you're amazing. Lareth's buffing himself. Dying, blah, blah, blah. Come on, guys. Oak. Could you bull strength, Lily? Could you possibly pick a better path than that? If not. Parsony, okay. Get on in. We need some help. You can't do it this turn, though. And you know something that I keep forgetting I can do? Is this. I believe the fungus, the type is completely random, and I have no idea what that does. Hopefully it doesn't do anything too horrible in a radius and hurt Lily and Ulk. That would be rather horrible. What? Oh, that's the guy I warped his weapon. He has no melee weapon? Really? Are you stupid?
Certainly.
Why, oh why? Like, I can understand being primarily ranged, but you should still have a backup melee weapon, and you did 11 damage to Fernok. Could you please not do that?
Yes.
I don't have time.
Yes.
I have no idea what that thing does, by the way. Spiritual weapon, just out there somewhere. I also believe with spiritual weapon, Luke could grab it and use it as a normal melee weapon. I believe.
At once.
All right, buddy. Let's get you in the room. Priest, we know his name's Lareth, because you know. The lieutenant screamed it out, the guy with the strange S name? Yeah. Like I said, this is the big combat of the area. Oh no, you're right next to. Oh, the guardsman's disabled. Well, then again,
very well.
Get you back out of there. At least I got the bull. Did I get the bull strength off? I think I did. And you really don't have anything else I can do. Let's just shoot somebody. Why not? Considering all of the bolts and stuff I've gotten you enable, I might as well use it. Oh! Acid damage? Does that look like an animation for a, Melf's acid arrow? Not the same sound effects, but that's what it sounded like. Or what it looked like, rather. Silly me. You're disabled, there's really no point in me attacking you. Can I reach this guy and attack him? No. Fernok, you need to run away again. I can fix Fernok's, like, bad scores and whatnot if I give him nice stuff. I'm probably going to make a priority of giving him some extra HP at some point. At some point. Like, I'll get around to it. Oh, Lily's not going for a while. And there's. Oh, boy. This could be bad. Stumpy is not going to be able to beat the priest in one hit. I can tell you that much. You're now fully dead. Oh yeah, acid damage of 7. Ooh. Yeah, that 5, that's non-lethal damage. I think it's also called subdual. She takes a little bit more damage. She's actually going to become unconscious. Subdual damage does recover, I think, 1 point every hour, is it? I'm not actually sure at the moment. It's really not that important.
Yes, sir.
What is important is that I go heal Lily. Yeah, and also remove the non-lethal. Wow, that I'm liking this figurine despite Turgeon's opposition to it.
Done.
Alright, so he's out of the picture. Lily, could you please murder the intent? Thank you, they are clearly evil. 23 on a non-lethal. Yeah, just a little bit.
Certainly.
Not to mention, you know, evil in the moat house. By the way, I don't know if you can see this or you notice this. Not only is there a little ring around Lareth here, there's also a little blue thing around his weapon. I think that denotes it might be magical. Critical hit of 7, that's not bad. Especially since I pulled that out with a little dinky spell. Yeah, I'm not going to use Hold Person. Let's just heal Stumpy. Not enough time.
Well, yes.
Let's get you up there. And of course he hits Furnock, right?
As you command.
Come on, Stumpy. You're blessed, you're enlarged, you should be able to hit things. Look, the Jackal can! Boy. So much text. Lily. Kinda getting paranoid. Now let's just shoot this guy. I've pretty much used up all of his spells anyway. In one combat. If you haven't noticed. Let's see. Actually, where is Lily? Lily's there. If she uses her Lay on Hands ability.
As you wish.
Have you heal Stumpy? Considering Stumpy's missing like 25 HP. That's probably the better option. As to damage, I've officially become a big fan of this figurine. Let me tell you.
Yes.
Badly injured. You should have your Lay on Hands. Use. Please heal yourself. Thank you. I can't believe I have to actually remind her to do that. But, you know... let's send you after some of the peons. I think Stumpy, with two healers behind him and the Jackal, can handle the priest. Just saying. There's one gone. Yeah, let's heal Stumpy even more. 11 HP on a moderate, that's pretty pathetic, buddy. Yeah, so this thing's done 6 damage to on each turn to a bunch of dudes. That's not bad. I don't even think that's in one of my tests of this item, or was it recorded? I don't remember. It summoned this ball thing and it was hitting for like 20s and 30s and stuff. It was pretty nuts.
Right away.
If Stumpy could hit, that would be nice. I mean, he's enlarged. He has Bless. Well, actually, Enlarge makes it harder for him to hit, doesn't it? From what I think of it. Yeah, I'll just shoot that guy, preferably hit him. Remove him from the combat. Good job. That's exactly what I wanted you to do.
Okay.
Actually, you know what?
Yes, sir.
Roll Strike Stumpy. Improve his to hit even more. Could you hit the priest, Mr. Ficamid? Probably horribly mispronounced, but it is what it is.
Certainly.
If I can get Furnock behind the priest and have him sneak attack him, that would be nice. It would be. Probably not going to happen. Oh my god, Stumpy, come on. Type opportunity. Finally, somebody hit him. You're going after Furnock? I don't know. Yeah, we need to get rid of this guy. You can't see him from
there
inside.
You
were still in the hallway? Oh yeah, that's right. I had to remove you.
Right away.
badly injured at 28. You're just not cooperating with me, Mr.
Very well.
Acid thing. How many hit points? Nah, you just hurt it 4.
Done.
It's not going to kill you, but you should be pretty... Yep, you're badly injured. Excellent. Can I run to you and attack you? Probably not.
Okay.
No! Not my face!
That is so appropriate with a critical hit. Oh, that was amusing. That was fantastic. I am very happy now. Before, kind of, you know, not in a great mood, but that...
Certainly.
You know, I don't know what it is. Like, the whole combat has gone pretty mediocre. Like, I've been hanging on using most of my spells. But, you know, not my face after getting hit with a critical attack. That's amazing.
Yes.
You don't really have much of a chance, do you, buddy? Especially with that coming at you. Jeez. Acid damage 6. I could probably shoot you with Ulk and end this combat. Wow. Okay, just predict the future, RPG. So this, all of this, this is probably worth a decent amount of experience. Where is my logbook, reputations, ego? Most combat from one... Yep. Thoughts of total experience gained, 42,000 for this combat. It just killed, sword by CR, so he was the highest. But not on the CR. Most critical hits, Stumpy. Lily still got that going. Yeah, and of course, Stumpy's up to 68 kills already. Pretty significant, but that required a ton of buffing.
Okay.
Especially to Stumpy. Ooh, white pearls. My inventory is going to fill up very quickly. Hand axe. Always pick up jewelry. Like, even this plain copper ring, pick that up. Just because it's made out of something... Like, something that I had to explain to a couple of players. Just because it's made out of something... Ooh, magic ring. Give that to you. Just because, if I can finish the sentence, just because something is made out of something plain, something ordinary, like copper, which isn't too fantastic, just because it's made out of something crappy, doesn't mean that it's going to be crap, because, artistry... the craftsmanship, the amount of detail affects the price too, not just what it's made of. These, of course, earn a stack, so it's not going to be too fantastic. But it is what it is. Silver breastplate. That probably sells for a decent amount, considering it's made out of silver. But you're using Logic RPG. Anything could happen. But, ooh, money and some crossbow bolts. Take those. I'll take those all day, as a matter of fact. Now, assuming that the game loves me, and knows what it's doing, which is probably not the case, whoever I warped wood on, I think it was this guy, has crossbow bolts, but no weapon. Thank you, game. Attention to detail is my favorite.
Yes, sir.
No weapon destroyed and all that. Because it would be kind of funny to completely destroy his weapon, and for me to loot his corpse and be like, oh no, here's the weapon that I supposedly destroyed. Not a lot of money.
Okay.
From each of these guys, but it is, you know, 2 platinum pieces. That's a fair amount.
As you command.
And I've got a decent amount of crossbow bolts out of this, too. 248 and 196. Yeah. So I'm not going to need those for a while. Of course, you know, not spending the time to... I can use that multiple times per day? What? That's pretty bonkers. Okay, identify magic ring. Plus plus one to protection, freedom of movement, one of these low-level...
Very well.
Freedom of movement, yeah. One of the low-level rings that you usually get. Usually freedom of movement, I don't give that out. I usually give that out later. Because, I don't know, in my mind, it's a better item than a ring of protection plus one. I don't know. That is just me. Plus one magical breastplate. That's quite nice. I don't think Fernok's going to be proficient. Items. Nope.
Perhaps you would consider relieving some.
Parjani can't use it. Ul can't use it.
My pack is too heavy.
You can use it.
It's
what's your AC? 16, 17, 18. So that's actually a really good idea for you.
My pack is too heavy. I think some well-deserved rest.
So that brings
is
you up to 18. Not to mention that there's some added bonuses that it doesn't tell you from plus one, but that's
difficult to carry.
Shut up. That's besides the point. So that's nice. Got a nice magical breastplate for my cleric. Of course, I robbed it off of the corpse of an evil man, but that's fine. I mean, that's just setting the world back into order, back into goodness and all of that. Even though it is black and clearly the item of an evil man, you're rambling about nothing now, RPG. So that was pretty much the end of the Moat House. I have one more room to investigate. That's a lot of reading, though, and that's not really something appropriate for this time. That was worth a lot of experience, though. What does that put me up to individually? 8,413. You're a little bit behind, but that's fine. So yeah, 10,000, level 5. Ooh, that's exciting. That's not that far away. What was I before I got into this combat? A little over, 7,500-ish? I mean, yeah, it's 42,000 experience, but it's divided to 7 people. That's pretty, yeah. Anyway, next time, the end of the Moat House, and then I need to go somewhere else. Until then...